The first SEO pillar is technology. If the technology of your website is not Google friendly, your website will have problems ranking on the search engine. What do I mean with that? Well, the first off, your hosting company needs to be a good, solid hosting. Of course, you need a good support system, but it also has to be really fast. And that has everything to do with what kind of servers do they have? What kind of OS are they using on their server? Are they using Web Accelerator? How fast is their DNS system? All these technology things are very important when choosing the hosting company. If you're still looking for a hosting company, or you have the idea that your hosting company is not that fast, the link is in the description of a very good hosting company, which is also very cheap. The second thing in technology is, of course, the theme you are using. Lightweight themes are very important within the WordPress ecosystem. I personally recommend the Hello theme from Elementor, if you're building with Elementor, or just the Divi theme, which has the page builder and Divi all inside of it. This makes sure that you only need the plugins that you need for your website, because the Divi plugin is already built in the Divi theme, and the Elementor Pro plugins are hooking perfectly inside of the Hello theme of Elementor. These are my two themes of choice. Another important one are the plugins. How many plugins do you use on your WordPress website? The more plugins you have, the more it tends to slow your website down. And a slower website is definitely not what Google wants to recommend to its visitors. But also, sometimes specific plugins can really hurt your SEO rankings. For example, the Jetpack plugin, I don't like it at all, as it tends to really slow down your website. Also, the opt-in monster plugins, I completely don't like them, as they really are big and I get the feeling they're really slowing down my website. So please don't use them. Also, your SEO plugin is very important which one you choose in terms of technology. I've created a comparison video about the three top SEO plugins and which one you should really choose to build on your website. Also, a translation plugin. Which translation plugin are you using to translate your website? This bloated software that really slows down your building process, translation progress, and your entire website. Also, your sitemaps are very important to have in place. That's why I choose the right SEO plugin, as it will serve the right sitemaps to the search engines. Make sure to also use rich snippets whenever you are eligible to use them on your WordPress website. Why? It really gives on the little edge with the stars and the reviews and all the things that really works well within the search results. Make sure to utilize them if you have content that is ready for rich snippets. The last one in this pillar is using next gen web formats for your images and videos. For example, the WebP format or the SVG formats are way better than GPG or PNG. How to convert your images to the next gen formats? Well, they're all kind of plugins that do that for you. Then we go to the second pillar, which is content. Content is and always be king on the internet, especially when we're talking about the AI generation right now, when content is very important, what is true and what is false on the internet. Especially when you have little gray hair, you can speak out of experience and you know everything about your certain niche. Make sure your content is unique. It has a lot of amount of words, like 1200, 1600 words per in-depth subject, and make sure you have written it yourself. You can use AI, for example, to generate ideas. And if you're not such a good of a writer, you can actually use AI to enhance your text. But the basics, in my opinion, should always be from you. But also make sure that there's a hierarchy inside of your content. What do I mean with that? Start with the H1, below that there are H2, subject, text, another H2, more text inside the H2. Maybe you're talking about different types of content, different types of subjects, H3, maybe an H4, then we go back to H2. And this way you build up your content so that it's easily to read, but also very good for the search engine, so they can really define what this content is all about. Also, when writing in-depth articles with a lot of hierarchy, make sure to use your table of contents block or table of content plugin to actually start at the beginning of your content with all the subjects being covered inside of your post or your page. This will really help the search engine determine what it's about and also help visitors to skip to the right point inside of your article. Then of course, make sure that the meta is perfectly in order on your post or page. SEO plugins really do a good job with helping you out on how to form your title and how to form the description of your content. Make sure that it covers your information, but also important keyword on the front, and make sure that it's clickbaitery enough so that people actually click on your content and start reading it and interacting with it. Very important for SEO. When uploading images to your content, make sure that the file name actually mirrors the focus keyword, mostly on front of the file name, then your brand name, but also a description of what this picture or image is actually about. Don't be fooled, the AI of the search engines know exactly what this image is about. If you're using words inside of it, if someone's happy or unhappy, it's all inside of the AI systems to rank certain images. Also, of course, don't forget the alt text added into your images, because it's very important for people with visual handicap, because they use screen readers that will actually read on the web page, but also will read out the alt text of the image so they know exactly what this image is about. And last but not least on this pillar, make sure that your website is thoroughly secured. Check out my tutorial about securing your WordPress website, because I have seen many times when websites got hacked, they are totally being tanked with all these search engines because their website is now infected with malware, but also are spreading a lot of spam pages throughout the search engines. And trust me, search engines don't like hacked websites. And then the last pillar of SEO is link building. Very important, do not underestimate it. I knew a guy who once picked up a book about SEO, and the title was All You Need to Know About SEO. So he bought the book, highly enthusiastic about it, went home, opened up the book, and the first page was only three words: get more links. So he's like, okay, get more links. Next page, three words, get more links. Second page, page after that, 100 pages, three words, get more links. Link building is very important. Make sure to get high quality links from other people's their websites, because they're linking to your high quality content. This way, the search engines will really recognize you as the author, but also as an authority on your subject matter. And guess what? Authorities with high effort and high quality content will actually surface on the search engines. And you might say, how do I get links from external websites? Well, you can always create a press release, and inside of this, some research in your niche so that people might actually place links to that research, which is very high quality and high effort. Yes, that's not something you can do easily, and that's why it's high quality, and that's why you receive a lot of links. But there are actually two rules that on link building are very important that I have to warn you for. Never, ever buy links. I have seen people that buy link farms or link packages for $500, you get 20,000 links. Trust me, all those links are very low quality. And if Google sees that you are growing way too fast in your link building, and they're non-organically, by that I mean they're not from news websites, then you might get penalized for that and your content will tank in the search engines. Trust me, never ever buy packages from shady companies. Also another thing, never ever get links from the three P's: poker websites, porn website, or pill website. Those three markets are red flags to search engines. Never ever go in there to get some links to your website. And yes, I've seen happen when people want to destroy their competitors, they just start buying all these links on these three shady niche markets. And it actually worked, and it was a nightmare for them that their competitors bought that, and it was a mess. So don't ever do that. It's not ethical, and you don't want to ruin someone else's life just because you want to gain an extra buck. Please don't go there. Now, the best links to get from external websites are actually inside of their content. They have paragraphs with text, images, all these things SEO optimized. And inside of the text, your focus keyword is right there, which is actually a clickable link that go to your website. A do follow link through your page, and that will give the right signal to the search engines that this content is especially about this subject. Now, those are the best links you can get. But you can also do those with internal link building. About the topic, make sure to have breadcrumbs on your entire website if you have a lot of content, so that the hierarchy and the place of the content is very logical for search engines, but also for your visitors. So the breadcrumbs are really important to have installed on your website. Make sure to also use different kind of levels. By that, I mean in your URLs, you have, for example, your website /subject1/subject A. And in subject one, you also have subject B, C, and D. But then on subject two, you also have subject A, B, or C. All that is categorizing your content, make them buckets real deep so you can put in all your content inside of your different kind of buckets. And make sure that there's internal link building between those buckets so Google and all the other search engines know exactly what this content is about and by what subject they belong to. Very important for your internal link building. Also, make sure in your other content to link to other subjects inside of the text. Remember those high quality links inside of your text with the exact keyword go to your own pages. Make sure that they're in there, but don't overdo it. I see a lot of people on websites just put in 50 links in just one article of 1200 words. Please don't do that. It is way too much for a normal person to walk through the text and think like, hey, this is interesting. But this is also interesting, it's too much, and people will not react great to all those links inside of your text. Make sure there are two or three internal links inside of one piece of content so that people can actually follow those links through other pieces of very interesting, high quality, high effort content. And the last thing I want to tell you about link building inside of your footer, you can place special links that go to your landing pages that are not inside of your main menu. So those pages could be pillar content or cornerstone content, whatever the name is in your SEO plugin, and you can use those footer links to actually push the value to those cornerstone content on your website. To do that, make sure to have the right SEO plugin. So make sure to watch this video right here, as it will explain exactly to you which SEO plugin I've tested out and advise you to use on your website.